Hello, hello, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome. Please subscribe down below. If you've been here before, welcome back. Thank you for coming back to the video. My voice is a little weird and hoarse. I'm a little unwell. So today's video is just a little bit different. So let me give you a bit of a backstory. So first of all, there's a plane. Always a plane in my videos. Always a plane. So a bit of a backstory. I got really sick a few weeks ago. It took maybe about 5-6 days for me to get healthy at least and back on my feet. But what it has done, even in the weeks subsequent to that, is that I felt myself having that general lethargy and malaise and like just down, Debbie Downer syndrome that comes with being sick. And I found it very difficult for me to get motivated. So not only just generally in life, but with my goals and stuff, I sort of just have been on a bit of a go slow. So I started to read a lot about it and try to figure out like, okay, what can I do? How can I improve? There's some things I read and some things I've started to put into practice that I think are really important. So I decided to share with you 8 things that I learned. It's sort of ways to stick to your goals. Many of these things you probably already know. It's just important to put them into practice. So I'm just going to put it out here as a reminder for the people who've heard all this stuff before. So it's really just 8 ways. 8 is my lucky number. I don't know why 8 is my lucky number. I just chose it one day when I was young. So these are sort of my 8 ways. If you have anything else, please add it down below that you can stick to your goals and you can like crush your goals. So yeah, with that, let's just go right to it. My eight ways that you can stick to your goals no matter what, you know, no matter what's going on. So the first one is visualize. So I know that you've heard so many times about vision boards and stuff like that. I really think the more that I use visual tools to really look at my goals and pay attention to my goals, it's really, really working for me. So if you have this big grand goal, you know what kind of car you want in the future, you know what kind of house you want, you know what you want your family to look like, you have these visions for yourself, make actual visual representations of those and put them somewhere that you get to see them every day. So some people put them up on a board, just cut out like pictures and stuff from magazines or whatever and put it on a board, and then they get to see it every day. For me, I have a WhatsApp group with myself, so I send very many of my pictures and a lot of stuff just to myself. I also save very many things on Instagram, and I just always go through, every once in a while I go through and look at it and imagine it and think it and just believe it, you know? So visualize is number one. Number two, and this happens a lot, avoid instant gratification. So every once in a while, particularly, well, my story largely with my motivation and my goals had to do with weight loss and with chasing a healthier lifestyle. So for me, instant gratification would be like grabbing that bar of chocolate, grabbing that soft drink that I probably shouldn't have, etc., etc., because it's what I wanted in the moment. So avoid that situation where you want to instantly gratify and start to think about the bigger picture and visualize what it is that you're going for and keep moving towards that. So if you really pay attention to the fact that you're going towards something, you stop for a second before you have that chocolate bar, before you do that thing you shouldn't do, before you miss that day in the gym, before you don't record on the day that you were supposed to record. You know, if you think about the bigger picture, you learn to avoid instant gratification. So one way that I found that sort of makes sense for me with regard to instant gratification, when I know that it's something that I really shouldn't have, I'll take my brain completely out of it, and I'll just do it. That's now number three. So take your brain sort of and the thinking and the doubt out of it, and that's number three. So for example, I like to call this like just do it, you know, like Nike. So just do it. So what that means for me is like, my immediate answer is no. If I know that it's something that I shouldn't eat, I just immediately say no. And now I've already said it. So if I'm out somewhere and someone is walking around and offering cake, and I know that that day I shouldn't have cake, I've had too much sugar that day, or if I've already had a piece and I shouldn't have another one, I just immediately say no. And then I've already said it. It's out loud, you know. I've removed my thought from it. I've just said no immediately. Or in the other instance, it would be Let's say you want to snooze the alarm, right? That's something you have to think about. So imagine, like, your alarm has just rang and you know that you're supposed to get up. Just get up. Like, just say yes. Don't think. Just say yes. Just do it. If you're supposed to be in the gym, just wear your gym clothes. Just go, you know? So I'm really starting to learn that just do it attitude, which is number three, that just do it attitude, also moves me forward and is starting to propel me forward. When I know that it's something I'm supposed to do, don't think about it. Just do it. Number four, this is something that I had absolutely stopped doing, and I'm really sad that I'd stopped doing it, and I'm glad that I'm getting back there. Look back at the things that you've achieved so far. So it's very easy to lose yourself when you're planning something and you're pushing for something and you want something. It's very easy to push yourself so hard that you forget what you've achieved up to this point. Don't forget that, because it starts to put things in perspective for you. So number four, which is very important, is look back at your achievements. Keep a record of the things that you've done so far. If you're starting a new business, keep a record of your milestones. If you're trying to lose weight, keep track of what you've lost so far. It's great to be able to look back and say, you know what? Yes, today was a really difficult day for me, or I don't want to start to do this right now, but this is what I've achieved so far. So look back at your achievements all the time. Number five is plan. So you've put up your vision board, or you've saved your Instagram pictures like I do, or you've sent yourself your pictures on WhatsApp of what you want to achieve in life, but now you need to create an actual roadmap to what it is that you want to achieve. So for example, you have this big weight loss goal, so let's first divide that into how much you want to lose per month, per quarter, and then figure out, to be able to do this, I need to be this kind of person, I need to work out this number of days in a week, I need to eat in this particular way, I need to do this healthier thing, and then stick to that, stick to the plan. Because if you lose your consistency with regard to sticking to your plan, you'll very easily lose momentum and then have no motivation to start again, if that makes sense. Some people can just go right back, and like when they've lost it a bit and can just go without a plan. I'm not one of those people. So for me, planning and breaking it down into more achievable, smaller mini goals sort of works really well for me. So break it down and just allow yourself to go step by step and plan a little at a time, and then you will find yourself, you know, it'll accumulate and you'll find yourself achieving your goals. I like to say mentors, and even if they're not actual physical people who you talk to all the time, get examples or mentors who have achieved, successful people who have achieved what you want to achieve, people who have reached that level of success that you want to get to. Pay attention to those people. What do those people do? How do they think? What do they, I mean, has a person who you look up to written a book? Read that book. Has a person who you look up to, do they have a page on YouTube that you can, you know, where they give like tips and tricks and lessons and life masterclasses? If they do, watch those and emulate and figure it out. So I call them mentors, even if they are not people who you necessarily have a one-on-one relationship with. Just get mentors and people who can help you. So I use the word examples or mentors, of people who can help you achieve, because they have achieved that level of success that you're after. Number seven, very, very important, accountability. So some people are able to keep accountable by themselves. Some people are able to just be their own accountability partner, and that's fine, and they can achieve it, and they are self-motivated and self-driven. I am not one of those people. So I then tell my sister what my goal is. I tell my mom what my goal is. That way, there is somebody else who knows what I'm trying to do, knows what I'm trying to achieve. In a situation where we find ourselves in a place where I'm about to do something that I shouldn't do, that's against my goal, then my sister will let me know, yo, you're not supposed to be doing XYZ because you want to achieve ABC. So find yourself an accountability partner. If you are able to be accountable by yourself, well and good, then the answer is be accountable, right? So accountability is number seven. And last but not least, number eight goes hand in hand with what I had said about planning. Break your dream down into something that you can achieve over a shorter period of time that will show you that you're going towards the right goal. So like I mentioned now, when we're talking about planning, if you want to lose 20 kilograms, Can we figure out how long do you feel if you act a certain way and behave and keep to certain goals and are strict with certain things? How long will it take for you to lose 5? Then let's plan for 5, and then the next 5, and then the next 5, and the next 5. And all of a sudden, you will have completely done all your 20 kilograms. The same with, say you want to read, you want to be the kind of person who has read 100 books by X time. Okay, let's divide that into 4 books per whatever, and then start reading slowly and figure it out like that. So break it down into smaller, more easily achievable, but it's not easy, it's just that it's easier to swallow, it's easier to understand. Smaller things that can be smaller dreams, mini dreams that will then accumulate to form this huge thing that you want to achieve. And those are my 8 tips to success, my 8 stick to your goals motivational pointers, right? So if you have anything else that you want to talk about, or any other tips that you have to keep like the motivation going to make sure that you're A1 and like always going for your goals, please let me know down below. I would love to hear them, well, read them. I would love to read them, and I'm sure they'd help somebody else who's also reading the comments. I am so happy to hear of anything. All information is good information. If you're also stuck in sort of a bit of a motivational rut like I was, please let me know also down below. We can talk about it there and figure out how to like get you out of the funk. But that is it for this video. Thank you so much for joining me. We shall talk in the future. Do not forget to subscribe down below, and tell your friend to tell your friend to tell another friend and another one that there is a very cool YouTube channel, that is this one, online. Then they can subscribe also. I will see you guys.